Welcome to Ecoholics. In this lecture, we'll understand the concept of GDP, that is Gross Domestic Product, an important concept for UPSC Civil Services examination, and this is an important topic for 12th standard examination as well. But this lecture is dedicated towards UPSC examination, so we'll first understand what's the meaning of GDP, what are the keywords in the definition of GDP, and we'll understand each and every word, the meaning of each and every word in the definition. That are keywords, so we'll define each and every word. Apart from this, after that we'll see that who calculates GDP in India and what are the important methodologies to calculate gross domestic product and how it is different from national income. So here we'll start our conversation with GDP. Now the GDP as defined as it is the final value of all the goods and services produced within a domestic territory in a particular financial year. So this is the definition. Now we need to understand the keywords inside it. Now it is the final value of all the goods and services. Now we consider the term final. So final value. Value means obviously in terms of prices. So whenever we see the value of a particular commodity, obviously the unit into prices. So what's the meaning of the first term? That is the final. The final value of goods and services. Now understand the difference between final and intermediate products. Now there are two types of products. Now first is final goods, like suppose we are engaged in the car production. Now in car production we need certain kind of raw material and inputs. Like suppose for example we are making a particular car. In that car we need glass, we need rubber, we need plastic, etc. There are n number of things. Now suppose the manufacturer of the car went to a particular place and demanded rubber for the production of the car. Now the demand of the rubber is obviously not the final demand, because this rubber is that particular manufacturer will use in the manufacturing of the car. So that rubber becomes an intermediate goods, and the car is obviously not used for further production. So car becomes your final goods. Now understand the difference between the final and the intermediate goods from the other perspective. Like suppose the car cost around 6 lakh rupees. So if a car includes the prices of glass, rubber, plastic, etc., it means this 6 lakh include the price of rubber, glass, plastic, etc. So here we need to understand that we only take the price of the car, not individually will take the prices of glass, rubber and plastic in the calculation of GDP. Because if we include, suppose in this particular car, rubber cost around 1 lakh rupees. Now if we include 1 lakh again as a car price and the rubber price, it will lead to double counting, because that 1 lakh rupees already included in the price of the car. So we do not include this in terms of the final value. So this is what we call the intermediate goods. Now under intermediate goods, we do not calculate their value in terms of the calculation of GDP. So what we have to do? We have to deduct the value of these intermediate goods. Now again, carrying the definition, like it is the value of all the final goods and services produced within a domestic territory. So the second keyword is domestic territory. Now under domestic territory, there are certain kind of things that we need to understand from the perspective of UPSC. Now suppose this is the map of India. I'm not drawing the full map. So here we can say that whatever the goods and services produced in this particular domestic territory is come under the term called domestic. Now what are the things will come under the term domestic? Like this is what we call the, there are two types of zone. This is what we call the 12 nautical miles. The particular, the border of the country is known as what we can say, that this is a territory of India as well. Now up to 12 nautical miles, this is obviously included in the territory of India. So whatever producing here at this particular point will also come under the calculation of GDP. Apart from this, suppose we are having any aircraft, or we have any aircraft carrier like we are having INS Vikramaditya, etc., that will also come under the category of domestic territory. So we can say aircraft carrier. Now here aircraft, like suppose for example Air India. So if Air India is actually working abroad, like working or flying away from the territory of US or United Kingdom or other countries, etc., that will also come under the domestic territory. Apart from this, any oil rigs we are having, or other embassies, consulates we are having, that will also come under the category of domestic territory. So this is how we can measure the GDP of a country, especially we can say from the India's perspective. So all these things will come under the term called domestic. Now the final term, that is, again I'm repeating the definition for you, like it is the final value of all the goods and services produced within a domestic territory in a particular year. So generally in a particular year means in a financial year. So India's financial year is from 1st April to 31st March. So this is India's financial year. So these are the three important keywords under this definition of GDP. Now we'll understand that who calculates GDP in India. So if you know the answer, you can pause this video and comment in the comment box, who calculates GDP for India? So the answer is the Central Statistical Office, CSO, calculates GDP for India. And we have changed the methodology in the year 2015. So National System of Accounting, and that is actually integrated towards the International System of Accounting given by United Nations. So now the system of calculating GDP in India is integrated with the calculation of other countries in the rest of the world as well. So CSO works under the Ministry of, we can say, Statistics and Program Implementation, popularly known as the MOSPI. So this CSO will work under, or comes under the Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation. So this is the work of CSO. Now understand the difference between the GDP and the GNP. Now if we are converting GDP to GNP, so the difference is simple about D and N. Now here domestic, from domestic to national, it means, what was the definition of GDP like? It is the value of all the final goods and services produced within a domestic territory in a particular year. Now we change the word from the domestic territory, we include the nationals. So here under GNP, the definition is simple, it is the final value of all the goods and services produced by the normal residents of a country in a particular year. Here now, normal resident, what's the meaning of the term normal resident? Now there are other terms also known as citizen. So there is a difference between normal citizens and the normal residents and the citizens. Now citizens, obviously, who holds the passport valid, that particular citizen is belong to a certain country. Like for India, you need to have certain amount of validity with the, we can say, with the valid passport you are holding. So that is the citizen of India. But here under national, you can have the normal resident as well. Now what's the difference between normal resident? Is generally their center of economic interest lies in that particular country as well. Like suppose I'm a foreigner and I'm working in India and I'm living in India, obviously I'm investing in India and I've been living in India since many years, so my center of economic interest lies in India. Now you can understand with a simple simple example. Like what's the difference between British Empire and the Mughal Empire? So the British Empire, the center of economic interest was Britain. So they were taking resources from India and taking into their country, that is Britain. What was the center of economic interest for Mughal Empire? That was India, because they came from Central Asia, but their center of economic interest lies in India itself. So that's the difference, normal residents and we can say citizens. So whenever we are converting from GDP to GNP, we just have to deduct this convert the domestic territory from the national normal resident. Now, if we say that we are converting GNP to NNP, net national product. Now, the net national product, there's one difference, like difference of G and difference of N. So here, the gross and from net. Now, there's a one term called depreciation. Now, depreciation means when a particular capital asset suffers from wear and tear losses due to lapse of time. Like, for example, you are having a building that obviously in a particular year, like 5 years, 10 years down the line, that will actually have certain amount of losses. So that is the wear and tear losses by using that particular building or etc. So whenever we deduct depreciation value from GNP, that will become NNP, net national product. Now we're converting net national product to net domestic product. What do you have to do? Obviously, changing from national to domestic. That's the only thing. So here, net domestic product, we can convert it from NNP to NDP by adding the domestic territory. Now they understand the difference between the domestic and national from the other perspective. Suppose this is a territory A and this is a territory B. Now this is our home territory, so we can say domestic territory. Now suppose one person working in the country A. So obviously that will be part of GDP. But a person, a resident, we can say a citizen of A, but working in a country B. Suppose this is a citizen working in country B. But this, that particular person, their contribution will not be included in the GDP of A, but they will be included into GDP of B. But since he was the national of this country A, whenever we are calculating GNP, that is gross national product or net national product, then what we have to do, we have to include his contribution in the GNP of country A. I hope you understand this simple definition. So we are looking into the perspective of GDP, NDP, NNP, etc. So you can convert everything from these gross net products. So this is how we can define the GDP, NNP in simple sense for UPSC perspective. And for the 12th standard level economics, you have to refer certain formulas, etc. So in the next lecture, we'll understand the definitions like methodologies. Like there are three methodologies to calculate national income. So which sector in India is preferring which methodology? So we'll see in the next lecture. I hope you understand this lecture. Please like, share and subscribe Ecoholics and click on the bell icon so you'll get the notification of each and every lecture. Apart from this, do comment in the comment box if you want any other topic or any suggestion if you have for us, do mention in the comment box. And I just want to tell you that we are having the mobile app of Ecoholics, and in that mobile app you'll get the full courses of economics optional, Indian economic services, economics for general studies, UPSC civil services, econometrics, mathematical economics and many other subjects. For that, visit our website ecoholics.in. So thank you so much. Have a nice day.